Tech It with Cathy Clugston on BBC Radio Ulster, BBC Radio Foyle and BBC Science.
Hello and a warm welcome to The Ticket, your weekly local entertainment guide. On the show tonight, we'll hear how the writer Rose McClelland moved from romances to thrillers.
A friend said to me, you know, that romantic lead was actually a real nutcase. And if you'd have made a few tweaks, that could have been really dark.
How Dublin singer-songwriter Fia Moon found her voice.
I was singing this like Barbie song over and over again, you know, that I'm a Barbie girl. I think I was like 3 years old or something. And ever since that, I realised I could kind of sing decent enough.
And what the legendary racehorse Shergar has to do with this guy. Rishma will explain all in the podcast review. Helen has picked out some new films, and on this Midsummer's Day, we've news of a dreamy piece of outdoor theatre for all the family. Out of Your Head is the latest novel by the Belfast author Rose McClelland. Like her last one, Under Your Skin, which was an online bestseller, it's a psychological thriller dealing with dark themes, in this case addiction, death and destructive relationships. Rose told me a bit about her writing history.
This is my fifth book. So my first three novels were sort of romantic fiction. And then I decided to make a change to psychological thrillers. So the first psychological thriller I wrote was Under Your Skin, which did really, really well. And now I've just released Out of Your Head. And I'm halfway through now writing my sixth book. So it's just all go.
Was that sort of easy territory to get into, Rose? Because it's quite a leap from romance to psychodrama.
Yeah, well, it was in my third book, actually, that after I wrote my third book, a friend said to me, you know, you could have easily changed that to a psychological thriller because that guy, that romantic lead, was actually a real nutcase. And if you'd have made a few tweaks, that could have been really dark. And that sort of made me think. And then I thought, you know what, I'm going to try writing this. And I just found I just loved writing this genre.
Yes, the dark side is obviously appealing, I suppose, for all sorts of reasons. Tell us a bit about Out of Your Head, without obviously giving too much away. Tell us what you can about the story. What happens?
It opens with a car accident where a man is seriously injured and his daughter's in the car and she is close to death. The detectives arrive on the scene and they're not quite sure what's going on. It doesn't look like a straightforward car accident. It looks like he could have either driven into the wall intentionally or there could be other factors involved. So it's kind of around that mystery surrounding that accident, and then we start to kind of have the unravelling of the characters and what's going on behind the scenes.
And what's interesting is the way you write each chapter is from a different character's point of view. So we have Liam, the central character, then we have his partner, the mother of his child, a co-worker, and we see things from their point of view. Did you start with that aim in mind to write in that way? Did you find that a useful device?
Yes, and I did that for the previous book as well. And I think the reason why I did that is, one, I like writing in first person present because it feels so intimate and it feels like you're just talking to the reader. And then I sort of thought, well, you can't sustain that for a full novel with one character. And with every story, there are several sides to the story. So I wanted to find out, well, what's going through Liam's head through this and what's going... And each time you kind of bat between each character, your views change. Like, oh, what's going on here now that you've heard? It's a bit like being in a courtroom and hearing someone's point of view and then hearing someone else's point of view.
Yes, because what it also allows you to do is slightly mislead us and take us down different paths, isn't it? Because we're not sure who to believe.
Exactly. Yes, exactly.
I'd love to hear a bit, Rose. Would you have a passage you could read for us?
Certainly, yes. This is from chapter two, where the detective, Kerry, steps in on the scene. So here we go. I pull my car up to the edge of a sea of blue flashing lights and assorted glinting vehicles. I'm directed to the main witness. Abigail Jones, I ask. Detective Sergeant Kerry Lawler, can you tell me what happened? I heard the crash before I saw it, an awful squealing of tyres, and then a massive thud. It was so loud. Abigail is trembling, her face a mixture of shock and panic. Go on, Abigail, I say gently. I ran around the corner. I saw a car crashed up against a wall, a red car driving off. I walked up to the wrecked car and had a look at the damage.
She hesitates. Oh, I saw the little girl in the passenger seat. Her eyes closed. She was covered in blood. Is she dead? We don't know yet, Abigail, I say soothingly. The paramedics are over there dealing with it. I point towards the scene. What else did you see? Try to think clearly. There was a man behind the wheel, slumped over, unmoving. I dialed 999. The woman asked for the nearest house number. I ran over there. She points to one of the houses. 418, I told her. The wall next to 418.
Oh, it's such a page turner, Rose. I wondered how, is this something that you learn, how to build up that suspense, how to keep us going from chapter to chapter?
Well, what I do is when I read a book that I really love, I will go back and read it again and really study the plot and the twists and the turns and how they do it and what I liked about it. Or alternatively, if I read something I don't like, I'll ask myself, well, why did I not like that? You know, so I kind of really do, you know, study the structure of bestseller books and then try and copy it and try and emulate that.
Yeah, obviously we just sort of read it generally and don't think about structure, which is of course what should happen. We should be caught up in the story. Your last book, Under Your Skin, dealt with the theme of coercive control and sort of destructive relationships. It was difficult subject matter. Mm. And, you know, this too, you've alluded to the fact there's a possible suicide, and also there's some issues of addiction and alcohol dependency and so on. When you're writing about these subjects, you know, which are hard and tricky, do you have to do a lot of research? Do you have to talk to people affected? How do you go about trying to represent these issues accurately?
They always say that you should write about what you know. And I have had my own experiences of addiction in the past, and mental health issues. I did have a very close friend who unfortunately suffered from domestic violence, and so I was kind of with her every step of the way. But when I sit down to write a novel, I do start off with a theme, and I like it to be a really juicy, meaty theme that I can get my teeth stuck into. I was actually watching a programme the other day by the writer of The Line of Duty, and he said, you can't write a novel about an accountant unless the accountant is being blackmailed by someone. You've got to start with something really juicy, something that you can stick your teeth in, and it's going to give you lots of scope for conflict and drama. That was my intention, really, when I was sitting down to write those books.
That's the writer Rose McClelland, and Out of Your Head is out now and available via online booksellers.